Today's caper is presented by WQED Pittsburgh and WGBH Boston. Carmen's gang is bankrolled by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and viewers like you. All these people want to know, where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? And none of these people could find her. Jason Morgan. Jay Bach. Risa Mullen. Today's episode, The Taking of the Shrew. And this man is special agent in charge of training new recruits, Wrigley!
Oh! Good. Good. Proud. How are you guys? You okay?
Yeah.
Good enough. Let's get the chief up here. We got a lot of work to do. Chief, you there?
I'm here, Greg.
Wait a minute. Whoa, whoa. Come on. Oh, sorry. Greg. Let me,
get me in focus there.
No problem there. Yeah.
All right.
Sorry. Wait. Okay.
Good. Detectives, Carmen Sandiego and her cadre of creeps have pulled another caper. This time, they hit the Louvre Museum in Paris, France. Leonardo da Vinci's Mona Lisa, begun in 1503, is perhaps the most famous portrait in the Western world. The artist reportedly hired entertainers to keep his mysterious model happy while he painted. And happy she was, until Vic the Slick spirited her away.
Your hands off of me. Help! Somebody, help! You'll put me down this instant. Who do you think you are? Help!
Here's the skinny on the slick one. He's got a penchant for plaid and pinky rings. He's the kind of guy you wouldn't trust with a wet match. Your mission, Gumshoes. Bust Vic the Slick. Bring back the lovely Lisa, and then capture Carmen Sandiego. Greg.
Thanks, Chief. Okay, Gumshoes, what we're gonna do is start you off with 50 Acme crime bucks. Anytime you answer a question correctly, we'll give you 10 more crime bucks. And the two of you with the highest scores at the end of this round will then proceed to the next round, okay? Chief, let's go.
Detectives, Acme ArtNet has tracked Vic the Slick to the place where Leonardo painted Lisa. Vic was spotted pinching a pinky ring on the Ponte Vecchio, where they've been making jewelry since 1593. Now, this city is often called the birthplace of the Renaissance, and the artists Raphael, Donatello, and Michelangelo did some of their greatest works here. Their recent decision to become Ninja Turtles has initially been controversial, but is now regarded as just another example of their genius. Greg.
Thanks, Chief. Okay, Gumshoes. To what city did Vic take Mona? Was it Toulouse, Barcelona, or Florence? Remember the clues that we heard where Leonardo painted Mona Lisa and the birthplace of the Renaissance. Everybody's ready? Jason, we'll start with you. What do you say?
Florence.
Florence. What do you say, Jay?
Florence.
Florence. Risa.
Florence.
Florence. The answer we're looking for is Florence. Nice job, guys. Yeah. Yeah. That's the way to start that thing off, you guys. Tell you what, we'll take a little break. Let's find out a little bit about you detectives first, shall we? Jason, what do you like to do in your spare time?
I like to fish, and I like to ride my bike with my friends. I like to fish for my dad. He has a boat, and sometimes we go out on the ocean.
Great, great. Any career plans for you?
I would like to work in the field of astronomy because I think it's interesting to learn about planets and stars.
Great. Well, nice to have you on the case. Jason, everybody. And Jay, what do you like to do in your spare time?
I like to play soccer. I've been playing soccer for over 7 years.
Great. Any career plans for you?
Yeah, I would like to be a lawyer when I grow up.
And why would you like to be a lawyer?
I like to put people in jail.
Likes to put people in jail. There's Jay, everybody. You'll get along fine here. And Risa, how are you?
Fine.
What do you like to do in your spare time?
I like to play piano and take voice lessons. I've been playing piano for 9 years and singing for 4.
Great. Any career plans for you?
Yeah, I'd like to be a broadcast journalist on the news.
Great. Okay, Risa, everybody, welcome to the show, please. Okay, listen, we started off on this thing just the way we should. Everybody got the first clue right. Now we're going to go on to our second clue and try to... Wait a minute, let me get that. I'll be right back. Find out who this is. Acme Crime Net.
Acme a crime in that? It's Elisa. When are you gonna rescue me? If this jerk drags me through the Van Gogh Museum one more time, I'm gonna throw him in the Amstel River. Everything's written in Dutch. Get me out of here right now.
We're on the case, ma'am. Thanks so much for calling. Been a pleasure. Bye. I love it when she calls. Okay, guys, name the city. Is it Copenhagen, Amsterdam, or Antwerp? Remember the clues that we heard? Van Gogh Museum, Amstel River, and Dutch. Everybody's ready. Jason, you start. What do you say?
Amsterdam.
Amsterdam. What do you think, Jay?
Amsterdam.
Amsterdam. Risa?
Amsterdam.
Amsterdam. The answer we're looking for is Amsterdam. Guys. Yeah. Nice job. Okay. That means, Jason, you have 70. Jay, you have 70. Risa, you have 70. Ty, get... Yeah, come in. I think we have a serious problem here. What's the matter, dude? Hey, come on, what's the matter?
I saw Vic in a Japanese...
Come on, you can't die now. A Japanese what? A Japanese what? Come on.
An industrial center in Western Japan!
Come on, we need a little bit more. Just a little bit more. Come on.
The city's famous for Bunraku. Japanese puppet theater.
Is that it? That's all you had to say to me? Is that it? Haven't you got any more? Answer me!
Ah! It's just south of Kyoto.
Scott, the dying informant. One more time. Bravo. How wonderful. Gets longer all the time. Okay, name the city, you guys. Is it Yokohama, Osaka, or Nagasaki? Remember the clues that we heard from the dying informant. Industrial center in Western Japan, Japanese puppet theater, and just south of Kyoto. Everybody's ready? Jason, we'll start with you. What do you say?
Nagasaki.
Nagasaki. Jay, how about you?
Nagasaki.
Nagasaki. Risa?
Nagasaki.
Nagasaki. The answer we're looking for is Osaka. Wow. Yeah, tough break there. That means, Jason, you stay at 70. So does Jay. So does Risa. That's okay, guys, though. We're still on the right track. Okay, guys, that means only one thing. It's time for the lightning round. What's going to happen is now I'm going to give you a chance to try to pick up some extra crime bucks. What I have, three questions here. Each one of them is worth 5 crime bucks. The first one of you to buzz in and answer correctly gets 5 of them, okay? So listen closely. Here we go. Japan is governed by a parliament elected by Japanese people. What is the name of Japan's parliament? Is it the House of Commons, Congress, or the Diet? Jay.
Diet.
The Diet's right. Nice job. 5 for you. Okay. Question 2. In Japanese, the word gohan means meal. However, it also refers to a staple food that is eaten at almost every meal. Is this food rice, bread, or chicken? Jay.
Rice.
Rice is right. Nice job, Jay. Okay. Takes you up to 80. Now, let me show you what else we have for this third question of the lightning round. Take a look at this right here. Can you see that? Right? Okay. This paper crane is an example of the Japanese art of paper folding. What is this art called? Jason.
Origami.
Origami's right. Nice job. Back to you. Okay, so that means at the end of 3 to lightning round, Jason, you have 75. Jay, you have 80. Risa, you have 70. Very close game.
Greg?
Yeah, Chief.
Greg?
Yeah.
My office. Now.
Oh, okay. Let me go check with her, see what the problem is. I'll be right back with you guys. It'll be okay. Just my mentor calls. What's up, Chief?
Greg, you have been to Florence. You have been to Amsterdam. You have been to Osaka, and you still haven't found Vic the Slick or the Mona Lisa. Now, you have got to find Vic. He will lead us to Carmen Sandiego. Now, report, Buster.
Well, you know, we've had some problems here. I mean, you know, we've had the Mona Lisa calling me up. We have a dying guy dying in my office. It hasn't been a good morning.
Okay, I will sweeten the pot. I will give a trip anywhere in the United States to the gumshoe who captures Carmen Sandiego.
Great. But, okay, we can't do that.
Why not?
Budget.
Oh. Make that anywhere in the lower 48 states.
Hey!
Hey, it's still a heck of a deal.
Heck of a deal!
Right.
You can't get a deal like that. I mean, that's probably one of the finest deals you're going to find anywhere in
the
world.
No way.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Uh-huh. Gumshoes just want to remind you now, if you get Carmen Sandiego, you get that trip to anywhere in the lower 48 states, that's not bad. Now, to help you out, Acme Bugnet has just provided us a recording of a phone conversation between Vic the Slick and Carmen Sandiego. Watch.
Hey, boss lady, I gotta stash Lisa someplace. She's getting on my nerves.
Take her to a souk in Morocco.
Souk? What's a souk?
It's an outdoor market where you can find everything from snake charmers to pastries filled with pigeon meat. Vic, you'll love the souk. You can argue over the price of everything.
Yeah? Where is this Morocco place, huh?
It's a country in northern Africa on the Mediterranean Sea. And, Vic?
Yeah?
Lose the plaid suit.
Oh, Carmen, you got no style.
Okay, Gumshoes, name the city. Is it Algiers, Marrakesh, or Tripoli? Remember the clues that we heard? Souk and Morocco. Put the evidence together, come up with an answer as quickly as you can. Risa's ready, so is Jason, so is Jay. Jason, we'll start with you. What do you say?
Algiers.
Algiers. What do you think, Jay?
Marrakesh.
Marrakesh. Risa, what do you think?
Marrakesh.
Marrakesh. The answer we're looking for is Marrakesh. Nice job, Jay and Risa. Okay, that means Jason, you have 75. Jay, you have 90. Risa, you have 80. For our next clue, we now turn to Acme Celebnet with Special Agent Walter Cronkite. Walter.
Well, Gumshoes, here's the way it is. That crook is hiding out in a seaside city in Brazil, where the residents are called cariocas. Beautiful beaches, beautiful people, and the carefree lifestyle. It's going to be tough to keep your mind on work. Just remember the Acme oath. Duty first. No fun, no romance, no dancing the samba.
Okay, thanks, Walter. Name the city, you guys. Is it Brasilia, São Paulo, Rio de Janeiro? Remember the clues that we heard from Walter. Seaside city in Brazil, cariocas, and the samba. Jay's ready, so is Risa, so is Jason. Jason, what do you say?
Rio de Janeiro.
Rio de Janeiro. What do you think, Jay?
Rio de Janeiro.
Rio de Janeiro. What do you think, Risa?
Rio de Janeiro.
Rio de Janeiro. The answer we're looking for is Rio de Janeiro, you guys. Nice job. Okay, that means Jason, you have 85. Jay, you have 100. Risa, you have 90. Very close game going. Wait a minute, something's going on out here. Let's find out what it is. Hey, guys. Hey. What's up?
Calypso. 1, 2, 3, 4. Back to back. What did Belly say?
It was a zombie jamboree, took place in an island cemetery. It was a zombie jamboree on an island in the Caribbean Sea, just south of the Windward Islands. You can hear some great calypso bands. Zombies love the season of carnival. Oh, they get together in Bacchanal. They were singing back to back, belly to belly. Well, I don't give a dang, cause I'm stoned dead already. Back to back, belly to belly, a zombie jamboree. We do the limbo, back to back, well, belly to belly. Well, I don't give a dang, cause I'm stoned dead already, yeah. Back to back, belly to belly, a zombie jamboree.
Hey, Rockapella, ladies and gentlemen, come on. Thanks, guys. Man, they're good. They are good. Okay, guys, name the island. Is it Aruba, Trinidad, or Haiti? Remember the clues that we heard? South of Windward Islands, Calypso bands, and season of carnival. Put the evidence together, come up with an answer as quickly as you can. Jason's ready, so is Jay, so is Risa. Jason, we'll start with you. What do you say?
Trinidad.
Trinidad. What do you think, Jay?
Aruba.
Aruba. What do you think, Risa?
Trinidad.
Trinidad. The answer we're looking for is Trinidad. Nice job, Jason and Risa. Yeah, even though it's hard to say, a lot of people think that calypso music may have started on Trinidad, but, you know, that's kind of hard to say. Anyway, Jason, you have 95. Jay, you have 100. Risa, you have 100. Nice, close, tight game. I like this. Now, it is now time, though, for the final clue of this round, which means now you have to decide how much you want to risk. If you're right, we'll add that amount to your score. If you're not right, we'll subtract it from your score. You can risk 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, or 50 Acme Crime Bucks. Take a look right over here, if you will, please. Here's a portion of the world where we think Vic the Slick is headed. Now, if you know a lot about this part of the world, you may want to risk a lot. If you don't know very much about it, though, you may not want to risk quite so much. So, take a look at the map and think about it. Okay, looks like everybody's made a decision. Gumshoes, we have now tracked Vic. Yeah, Chief.
Greg, yeah. Hold on a second now. I'm getting a fax in here. Oh.
and it's from a fellow law enforcement agent, a ranger. It says, "We've chased your man from Waccahatchee to Waco, from Del Rio to Laredo. Don't worry, ma'am, we always get our man." Signed, Ranger Danger. Well, gumshoes, you're not gonna let some ranger beat you to the bust, are you? Go get him!
Thanks, Chief. Okay, guys, name the state. Is it Colorado, New Mexico, or Texas? Remember the clues that we heard? Ranger, Waxahachie to Waco, and Del Rio to Laredo. Come up with an answer as quickly as you can. Lay those answers right down in front of you there, Risa. Once you get an answer, okay, Jason has it, so does Jay, so does Risa. Jason, we're gonna start with you. You have 95. How much did you risk?
I risked 20 crime bucks.
You risked 20, but you said 10, so we're gonna have to go with 10, okay? All right, so that means if you're right, you'll go up over 100, you'll be in the lead. What do you say?
Texas.
Texas is right. Nice job, 10 more for you. Jay, you were ahead with 100. How much did you risk?
30 crime bucks.
30 crime bucks. This will give you 130 if you're right. How much, what'd you say?
Colorado.
Sorry, that's not right. You'll go down 30, down to 70. Yeah, but this isn't over yet. Risa, you have 100. How much did you risk?
I risked 30 crime bucks.
You risked 30. That means if you're right, you will then go into the lead, and you and Jason will go into the next round. What'd you say?
It's New Mexico.
Ooh, New Mexico's not right either. Okay, so that means you're gonna drop down to 70. Jason's in the lead with 105. We've gotta find out who's gonna go with Jason to the next round, which means we have to do a tiebreaker. So, Jay and Risa, hands on your buzzers, please. What I'm gonna do is read you some cities, and what you have to do is tell me what state that those cities are in. The first one of you to give me the correct answer will then go on with Jason, okay? Hands on the buzzers, Jay and Risa. Listen carefully, here we go. Haters Gap, Arlington, Charlottesville, Jay.
Washington.
Sorry, that's not the answer we're looking for. Keep guessing. Here we go. Shenandoah, Newport News, Roanoke, Richmond, Risa.
Virginia.
Virginia's right. Nice job. Risa and Jason going on to the next round. Good job. Jay, listen, man, you were a great detective. You did some great stuff today. We've assembled a kit that's going to help you in your next case. Chief.
It's the official Acme Crime Net travel kit, and it includes a World Traveler's Atlas, an official Carmen watch, a Carmen sweatshirt, and a subscription to National Geographic World magazine. And our thanks for all your good work on this case. And Jay, I salute you.
Thanks, Chief. Okay, guys, now it's time for you to go to Dallas, Texas. What you have to do is try to track down Vic the Slick and Mona Lisa. You have to find them and bring them back. But I want you to know, we do not send our agents out into the field unprepared. Chief, how about a briefing?
Acme Lone Star Net informs me that Vic the Slick has been tracked to Dallas, Texas. Here's the scoop. Big D, they call it. Home of the Cowboys and the Mavericks. Population just under a million. Eighth largest city in the U.S. Founded by John Neely Bryant in 1841. The boys down at Photo Recon have put together a few slides. Cotton Bowl Stadium. Vic the Slick loves a crowd, and he'll find one here. Seats 72,000. Now, Vic's role model is J.R. Ewing, so check out South Fork, the ranch used on the TV show Dallas, popular tourist attraction too. Now, if Mona Lisa gets lonely, Vic may take her to see a few friends. Best bet? Dallas Museum of Art, Impressionist, African, and modern artwork. She'll have plenty of company. Biblical Arts Center, various exhibits relating to the Bible. Now, don't miss the Miracle at Pentecost painting. It's 124 feet long. Finally, the Texas State Fair. You know, back when I was just a little chieflet, I used to love to go to state fairs. Except for the time when Nosy Vanderbubble stuck cotton candy in my hair. Of course, I had my mom arrest him, so it ended up okay. I wonder if he's out yet. Well, anyway, that's Dallas, Texas Gumshoes, and it's time to head out into the field. Begin the Crime Net countdown. 5 are the senses you need, 4 putting crooks on the run, 3 rounds to fight against greed, 2 be sure justice has won. Go get 'em, Gumshoes!
Okay, guys, here we are in Dallas, Texas. Set the stuff down right there. Take a walk right over there.
Let me show you what we have. Here are the possible locations where you will be able to find Vic, Mona, and a warrant for Vic's arrest. Now, the first thing you have to do is find the loot. That's the evidence you need so that you can get a warrant. With a warrant, you can then arrest the crook. Now, connect all three of those things in that order in a single turn, and you get a chance to try to catch Carmen Sandiego. Catch Carmen Sandiego, and you get that trip to anywhere in the lower 48 United States. Now, one more thing. You can pick any one of these locations that you want to, but if you happen upon the loot, the warrant, or the crook, you get a free turn, okay? Jason, you were headed to the end of the last round. You go first.
South Fork Ranch.
South Fork Ranch. Sorry, nothing there. Risa.
Thanksgiving Square.
Thanksgiving Square. Nothing there. Jason.
Bob Hope Theater.
Bob Hope Theater. Nope, nothing there. Risa.
Biblical Arts Center.
Biblical Arts Center. Nope, sorry, nothing there. Jason.
Bellow Mansion.
Bellow Mansion. Nope, nothing there. Risa.
Cotton Bowl Stadium.
Cotton Bowl Stadium. Vic the Slick. Okay, you guys, Vic the Slick, remember you have to do it in the right order. Loot, warrant, crook, use some strategy. Risa, go ahead.
Reunion Tower.
Reunion Tower. No, nothing there. Okay, Jason, go ahead.
Farmer's Market.
Farmer's Market. Nope, sorry. Risa.
Dallas Museum of Art.
Dallas Museum of Art.
Mona Lisa.
Okay, you got the loot, you get a free turn, go ahead.
Sports Hall of Fame.
Sports Hall of Fame.
The warrant.
You got the loot, you got the warrant. Do you remember where Vic is?
Highland Park.
Is he there? Highland Park. No, he's not there. Tough break. We turn him back around. Jason, it's your turn. Go ahead.
Dallas Museum of Art.
Dallas Museum of Art.
Men have named you.
Go ahead, Jason.
Sports Hall of Fame.
Sports Hall of Fame.
The warrant.
There's the warrant. Do you know where Vic the Slick is?
Cotton Bowl Stadium.
Cotton Bowl Stadium. Is he there? Yeah. Yeah. Come on here, Jason. Nice job, Jace. Good job. You took advantage of it. Nice. Stand right over here for me. You got Vic the Slick. Now the only thing you have to do is put him in jail, pull on this chain, and do it.
Vic the Slick's in jail.
Okay, Jason, listen, we're going to talk about your next adventure in just a little bit. But first, Risa, listen, you were a great detective. You tracked Vic the Slick all the way to Dallas. We got some great stuff for you. Chief.
We have a world band radio so that Risa can listen to broadcasts from all over the world. Nice work, Risa.
Okay, Jason, what I have for you now, inside there's a piece of paper, there's also a pen. What I want you to do is write down where you'd like to go if you catch Carmen Sandiego and win that trip. Do it. Bad at all. Okay, look, you got Vic the Slick, you got Mona Lisa back, you're having a good day. All you have to do now is... Let me answer this phone. Hold on just 1 second. See who's here. Hello? Yeah, he's right here. Hold on just a few days.
Hello?
I'm gonna need some company in the slammer. So here's the scoop on Carmen. Look for her in Africa.
Okay, Jason, looks like you and I are going to Africa. Chief?
Jason, here's a list of places Carmen may have traveled. Morocco, Guinea-Bissau, Benin, Tunisia, Nigeria, Cameroon, Congo, Zaire, Botswana, Sudan, Uganda, Zimbabwe, Ethiopia. Greg, take Jason to the map!
This is what it's all about right now. What you have to do now is track Carmen Sandiego through 7 different countries, identifying each country with a marker. When you're right, you'll hear this sound. But if you're wrong, you'll hear this sound. Now, if you're wrong 2 times, don't worry about it. Leave the marker where it is. But if you're right 7 times in 45 seconds, you will then win that trip to wherever you wrote in that portfolio. Sound good to you?
Yes.
Sound good to you guys?
Yeah!
Come on, Jay, let's go do this thing, man. Okay, guys, let's get 45 seconds up on the clock. Cheer him on, you guys. Good luck, Jason. Here we go. On your mark. Get set. Go. Carmen went to Morocco. You got it. Carmen went to Sudan. Nope, try it again. Try it again. Hurry. Sudan. Nope, come on back. Come on back. Carmen went to Uganda. Uganda. Try it again. Try it again, Jace. Come on. Come on back. Carmen went to Nigeria. Nigeria. Do it, do it. No, try it again, try it again. Come on back. Carmen went to Zaire. Zaire.
That's it, come on. Come over to Ethiopia. Yeah. Oh, out of time. You got 3 and 45 seconds. Give him a round of applause, you guys. Nice job, Bruce. I tell you, sometimes, man, sometimes Carmen is just tough to catch. That's all it is to it. But remember, you got Mona Lisa back. You got Vic the Slick. That's not bad. Chief, what do you say?
Jason, we're all proud of the good work you did throughout the day. And we here at headquarters, well, we pitched in and purchased a portable CD player we thought you would enjoy. And a selection of CDs from around the world.
Okay, thanks, Chief. Hey, listen, that's not bad, right? I mean, you got that's not bad at all.
No.
Look, you've had a great day today. You got Vic the Slick. You've been doing a lot of work for us. There's one more thing I want you to do. You know what it is. Do it, Rockabella!
Sneaks around the world from Vienna to Carolina. She's a sticky finger filter from Berlin down to Belize. Take me for a ride on a slow boat to China. Tell me
where in the world is
Carmen Sandiego?
See you there.
So in South Korea, my dinner is my uncle. My friend sees a three-layer mommy. See you in the blues. Well, we never Arkansas. Her steel Domingo from the jungle. Tell me
Nashville to Norway, Van Andrews, Zimbabwe, Chicago to Czechoslovakia, and back. Well, she'll ransack Pakistan and run a scan in Scandinavia. Next, she'll stick them up down under and go big pocket burn. She was the missing misdemeanor when she stole the beans from Lima. Tell me,
where in the world is
Carmen Sandiego?
Oh, tell me!
Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego?
Tell me.
Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego?
Where could she be?
Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego?
This is Lynn Thigpen speaking for Where in the World is Carmen Sandiego. And remember, gumshoes can be boys or girls, but never, ever knavish churls.
Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego?
This program was made possible by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and viewers like you.
This is PBS.